On tonight's CTV News, Christchurch City Council has agreed to stop charging rates for residential properties left uninhabitable by recent flooding, and Black Cap skipper Brendan McCullum fronted to the media today about match fixing. This is CTV News, I'm Grant Mangan. Christchurch City Councillors have slashed rates for residents forced out of their homes due to flood damage.
Christchurch City Councillors unanimously decided to offer rates relief by 100% for residents forced out of their homes due to flood damage. The decision means flood-affected residents who were forced to move out of their homes in March will have their rates waived until short-term work is completed and the risk of further repeat flooding has been reduced. Affected residents will need to write to the council for the rates rebate. Short-term solutions are expected to be implemented within the next 2 months. The rates rebate for now is only until the end of June next year. Work being done for flooding mitigation continues today. Contractors are widening Dudley Creek. 300 millimetres of sediment has been removed from the channel. Excavation of the dirt and muck will allow for faster water flow within the creek. 100 cubic metres has been removed in total, and work will continue in the nearby streets surrounding the channel. Council staff and contractors are continuing to speak with local residents in the Dudley Creek area about the extent of the work being done. Initially, the cost for the rates relieved was suggested to cost less than $30,000 a month, but the figure continues to grow as more flood-affected residents approach the council, claiming they were missed out of the initial task force figures. If costs for the flood-damaged properties to get rates remission is more than $60,000 a month or over $700,000 a year, it is possible rates for other Christchurch property owners will increase to make up for the shortfall.
Sarah's Chief Executive Roger Sutton believes the City Council is doing a good job handling the flooding issues facing Christchurch residents.
Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority's Chief Executive Roger Sutton talked to CTV's Chris Lynch about the flooding issues facing Christchurch residents. The Christchurch City Council created a flooding task force to develop short-term solutions for flood-affected residents in Christchurch. CERA Chief Executive Roger Sutton says one of the first things done at CERA was red zoning thousands of Christchurch properties. He says if the land zoning hadn't been done, there wouldn't be hundreds of flood-affected properties, there would be thousands.
If we hadn't actually done that land zoning, then we would have had, you know, not hundreds of properties significantly affected, but thousands and thousands of properties affected. So a lot of the work we initially did has actually made a huge difference to the sort of flooding issues we've got now.
Earthquake Recovery Minister Jerry Brownlee said earlier this month the government isn't responsible to help the flooded out residents. It's the job of the Christchurch City Council. Chief Executive Roger Sutton acknowledges the flooding was made worse due to land damaged by the earthquakes.
We aren't responsible. I mean, under the law, actually, it is the council who are actually responsible for these issues. They've always been responsible. Some of the flooding issues we've got in Christchurch at the moment have been exacerbated. They've been made worse by the earthquake. But there are other areas of the city that have always had flooding issues, and actually there's always been a council issue there to sort out.
Roger Sutton says he has friends and staff members in the Heathcote and Flockton Basin areas. He says he can't imagine what it must be like to have to live in a flood-damaged home.
I think it's dreadful, eh? I mean, I'd find it really difficult to live in a house where they've been flooded that many times. I think that would just be horrible, horrible, horrible. So, I mean, there's really two issues. One is, like, the long-term. How do we solve these issues in the long-term? But what are those short-term solutions? And that's what we're expecting also the council to come back to us saying, these are the things we want you to do. But the thing is, Chris, I don't want to be sort of preempting what the council does. They're leading it. I think they're doing a good job in leading it, and I'm trying to back them.
Roger Sutton commends the job the Christchurch City Council are doing, finding solutions for flood-affected residents. He says there are practical things put in place to make things easier for those in distress.
There may be some simple things they can do with some of that dredging, removing trees and rivers, all those sort of simple, easier things that for some of those people will actually reduce the risk of flooding a lot.
Following the court amend the report stating the council's $534 million shortfall, everyone is now questioning every single dollar the council spent. The Christchurch City Council are still waiting for insurance payouts. Roger Sutton says they don't need to be rushed when making decisions.
If they can't resolve those issues in 7 weeks, it will simply take longer. You know, the council need to come to a good insurance settlement with their insurers, and they don't need people like me bullying them, trying to force them to take a settlement which is going to be suboptimal. They need to be having those negotiations with their insurers in a calm sort of way and not being pushed into doing a settlement too quickly.
Wanting the best for everyone in damaged homes in Canterbury. Joel Batista, CTV News.
Roger Sutton's full interview with Chris Lynch airs on Monday, the 26th of May, at 8:30. And New Zealanders are consuming record amounts of alcohol, and the binge drinking issue remains at its highest.
Statistics reveal New Zealanders drink 826 bottles of beer each every year. The World Health Organization, in their latest global status report on alcohol and health, reveal New Zealanders are drinking 10.9 litres of pure alcohol a year in 2010. That's well above the world average of 6.2 litres. 20% of New Zealanders don't drink. Taking that into account, the numbers of drinks per person consumed are even higher. National Addiction Centre Director Doug Salmon isn't surprised. The statistics revealed New Zealand is well above the alcohol harm line. Less than 6% reported consuming at least 6 standard drinks in one occasion. This number is lower than many other nations, but Doug Salmon says this conservative figure does not mean that binge drinking isn't a problem.
But just because other Western countries have a crisis on alcohol and ours is on par with that doesn't mean that we haven't got a crisis. We are a heavy drinking culture. We're paying the price for it in both injury and in chronic disease. And until we are able to get the excessive commercialisation of alcohol down, we're going to continue to suffer as a country.
6% of New Zealanders binge drink. That's 170,000 people. Doug Salmon says most are young people.
I think it should be put back up to 20. Frontal lobe maturation in humans is not really completed until the early 20s.
Alcohol consumption has been rising since 1999, when the legal age was lowered from 20 to 18 years of age. Professor Doug Salmon says the age limit was there for a reason.
Certainly 18, a teenage purchase of alcohol, particularly in a country like New Zealand where there is this disconnected youth culture, so teenagers drinking by themselves without the guidance of adults, makes it particularly a dangerous situation.
Also increasing drinking levels, beer became legal in supermarkets in 1999. Alcohol has only been made more accessible. Another significant factor is marketing, targeted more at young people and women, demographics that historically didn't used to drink as much alcohol as men.
The alcohol industry has been targeting both young people and women with their marketing because prior to that, these groups were not as big a drinkers as men had more traditionally been in New Zealand.
Professor Doug Salmon hopes something will be done to prevent the problem from growing before it becomes too big to handle. Joel Batista, CTV News.
Local alcohol bans are up for consultation in 3 areas.
Submissions are being called for on local alcohol bans. The Christchurch City Council is proposing to introduce 3 new bans around the city. 3 temporary alcohol bans have already been in place across the city in the past year at the request of the community and New Zealand Police. The 3 temporary bans have proven successful and are now hoped to be made permanent. The bans will affect the Riccarton Island area, Addington and Sumner. A permanent ban 24 hours a day, 7 days a week already applies. But the proposal is to extend it to the Upper Riccarton and Islam area. And it's proposed to have bans in Addington and Sumner on special occasions, such as Cup Day and New Year's Eve. Consultation for the alcohol bans opened on Monday.
Coming up, Black Caps captain Brendan McCullum faced the world's media in Christchurch today about match fixing.
Al Jazeera News, international news right off the satellite, bringing you up-to-the-minute coverage of world events. Al Jazeera News, weekday mornings at 6 o'clock, right here on CTV.
Introducing My Free View.
This fella doesn't just preserve your right to watch free digital TV. It fits your viewing around your life. Too busy putting out fires? Record at the touch of a button.
Want to watch one channel and record another?
You can. And if you need to nip away,
hit pause, even a live show.
For a one-off payment, you can enjoy free view when it suits you, not someone else.
It's like having your own TV station at home without monthly fees or contracts. My Free View. It's Kiwi for TV.
Hi, I'm Mark, and welcome to Stay Well Pharmacy. Whatever the season, Stay Well Pharmacy has you covered. As an integrated pharmacy, we stock all the well-known pharmacy medicines, as well as quality nutritional and herbal treatments. Our team of pharmacists and full-time naturopath are here to help you find the products and advice to suit the needs of you and your family. So come in and see us at Stay Well Pharmacy, 27 Shands Road in Hornby. Stay Well Pharmacy. Live well. Stay well.
Yuck, look at all this moss and lichen. I'm not getting up there, not in these heels. Time to call Mossbuster.
Mossbuster is a no-bleach, non-abrasive, biodegradable solution that has over 35 years of proven results. You can buy Mossbuster online for less than half the cost of other well-known products and can be yours for less than a dollar a litre. You just spray it on and let Mother Nature do the rest, or Mossbuster can do it for you. Check out our website or call the Mossbuster crew for a free quote. Mossbuster, 0800 88 1000.
Ready to go, mate? Flight leaves at 4:30.
Relax, mate. We'll park at Airpark Canterbury.
Airpark Canterbury, privately owned and operated with a free 24/7 shuttle service. Call 0800 Airpark or book online at airparkcanterbury.co.nz.
Be immersed in the unique cultural highlights Germany has to offer every Tuesday night with Discover Germany. Tuesday at 7 p.m. right here on CTV.
Canterbury's Community Patrol Group is celebrating 20 years of serving the community. Tomorrow, 15 patrol vehicles and a number of members representing the entire Canterbury Community Patrol team will come together in Christchurch. 17 community patrols with around 400 members operate around Canterbury. Senior Sergeant Apley says the members of these groups are all volunteers who raise their own funds to operate on behalf of the police. He says they act as the eyes and ears for the entire community. Black Caps skipper Brendan McCallum answered questions from the media this morning around the match-fixing saga.
Facing up to the country's media, but avoiding questions around match-fixing, New Zealand cricket captain Brendan McCallum in Christchurch for the birth of his third child, and in the media hot seat after a week where the focus has been on match-fixing allegations. Former Black Cap Chris Cairns has denied his involvement in match-fixing, calling any allegations against him lies. McCallum wasn't about to confirm or deny today that Cairns was the so-called Player X.
I can't comment on that.
Earlier this week, parts of Brendan McCallum's evidence to the International Cricket Council were leaked to media. The documents reportedly show Chris Cairns allegedly approaching McCallum to fix matches in 2008. 3 years later and again in 2013, McCallum's understood to have given evidence about the approach. McCallum says he stands by everything he said and has no regrets over his testimony.
I'm obviously disappointed about that, but there's nothing I can do about that now, so.
McCallum says he's had lots of support from around the world and he still loves the sport, despite the recent bad press around the match fixing.
There's a couple of circumstances which have slightly tainted the game, but there's also a majority of the people involved in the sport uphold the traditions and the respect for the sport which everyone loves, and I'd hope that the fans would continue to support the sport that everyone else is obviously trying incredibly hard at.
New Zealand's co-hosting the ICC Cricket World Cup with Australia earlier next year. There's no question these allegations are leaving a nasty stain on New Zealand cricket.
There's an investigation occurring here in New Zealand, and that's a very sad thing for everyone involved in cricket, and we can't recall from that. We need to stand up and address issues if there's negative outcomes for us here. There's no question about that, and everyone acknowledges we have a problem.
The Players Association says match fixing is an age-old problem, dating back to the ancient Olympics.
Events around the world are broadcast everywhere. The betting markets have increased. We as sports now need to respond to the fact that through betting markets, illegal betting markets, broadcast events, that the problem around fixing and corruption is much bigger than it was historically.
Recent New Zealand legislation criminalises match fixing. New Zealand cricket's confident New Zealand has controls in place to stop the corruption on our shores.
What I think is a big risk for cricket going forward is actually not corruption around the international game. I think it's corruption around the domestic domestic T20 competitions around the world.
We have anti-corruption officials at every match. There are very strict systems and processes around international cricket. So as you sit here today, we're very confident about the international game.
The country will be waiting for further information to be released on this match-fixing saga. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Three Crusaders rugby players will run on the field this week sporting customised jerseys. Emma Cropper was at Rugby Park when the players received the special tops.
The Crusaders are training ahead of their game against the Highlanders this weekend, but it was these three local schoolchildren who stole the show.
Can I have a high five? There we go.
The children are the lucky winners of a charity auction.
This is awesome, eh? This is pretty cool.
Where the winners' names are printed on these customised jerseys for the players to wear.
Yeah, there's a few lucky names out on a few of the jerseys.
The Super 15 jerseys were auctioned off on Trade Me, with proceeds going to Plunkett. The Crusaders landed the highest bid on a jersey out of any of the Super 15 teams. The winning bid, $1,200 on the number 9 jersey. But for 6-year-old Julian Manton, having her name in bold on the front of Sam Whitelock's jersey wasn't the highlight of her day.
Having my photo on the guy's shoulders.
Despite that, the players are feeling proud about running out on the field in them.
Yeah, it's awesome. If I was 6 or 7 and seeing some people out there, on TV with my name on it would be pretty cool. And hopefully they're allowed to stay up a little bit later and watch the game. And it's something they'll look back on in a few years. Hopefully they'll really enjoy it. So.
The players don't get to keep the jerseys. After hopefully taking out a win against the Highlanders this weekend, they'll be returned to the winners to keep. Emma Cropper, CTV News.
Still to come, the business, traffic and weather updates.
Al Jazeera News. International news right off the satellite, bringing you up to the minute coverage of world events. Al Jazeera News. Weekday mornings at 6 o'clock. Right here on CTV.
Blackwells has a proud history presenting leading vehicle brands, extensive backup and service for a total one-stop driving experience. Holden, Mazda and HSV new and used vehicle sales, servicing, parts, paint and panel, Isuzu truck sales and service, all together in one convenient location. More selection, more value, more quality and more reasons to make Blackwells your number one choice. Visit Blackwells today, corner Waterloo Racecourse Road, Sockburn, or online at blackwells.co.nz.
Welcome to Caltex Redwood. We're a family-owned business proudly supporting our local community. We're open 24/7 for fuel and shop goods, and we have an amazing team of people ready to help you. Save at least 6 cents per litre using AA Smart Fuel Cards. We also offer great value on our LPG bottle fills. We have a full workshop and Bridgestone Tyre Centre. Our mechanics and tyre technicians will get your car sorted. Caltex Redwood. We're just down from St. Bede's on Main North Road. Caltex Redwood. What drives you?
You alright, mate? Can you hear me? Hey, you, can you hear me? Can you help me? I need you to call 111 for an ambulance.
If an accident happens and you didn't know what to do, prepare for what could be the longest wait of your life. Knowing before you need it, call 0800 Red Cross and enrol in a Red Cross first aid course today.
Come
come in and meet the locals at the Bush Inn Centre. Whether it's to grab a coffee on the go or to catch up with a friend over lunch or dinner, the Bush Inn Centre is the perfect place. With our unique range of shops, you'll find everything you're looking for and more. Our friendly locals are always happy to help. We have plenty of parking at the Bush Inn Centre, making your shopping experience just a little bit easier. So come in, meet the locals and shop Bush Inn. You'll find us on the corner of Riccarton and Waimari Roads.
Come dine with Country Catering at the Kaipui Golf Club Cafe. Enjoy our range of delicious $10 lunches, daily specials and other homemade goodies. Open to the public 7 days inside the Kaipui Golf Club. North end of William Street, Kaipui. We look forward to seeing you soon.
Well, it's Thursday, so that means here's Warren Head with the weekly business news. I'm Warren Head for headliner.co.nz. Good news today that there is some breakthrough downtown Christchurch in respect to car parking. With the decision by the Christchurch City Council to sell the old Crossings car park of about 200 spaces back to their co-partners who helped them build it back in 1998, the Carter Group. The chief executive of Carter Group today is Mary Devine, who was, of course, previously the chief executive of Ballantyne's, the big department store in close proximity to this site. It's been held for some time now that car parking has been the missing part of the jigsaw downtown. Without it, there's no real incentive for shoppers to come back into the city, and there's no real incentive for the retail precinct to get underway. The mayor is calling it a circuit breaker. The developers are hailing this as a breakthrough, and the car park building that will be going up will be a biggie, 534 spots in a car park retail building development of about $100 million by the Carter Group. Of course, the difference with the shopping centres around the other parts of the city is that there will be a meterage payment to be made, whereas it's free if you go somewhere else. So that'll still have to be sorted out because that, of course, will be a factor in what people think of it long term. In respect to the shopping centres, Kiwi Income Property Trust came out this week. That's the owner of Northlands, and said in their statement that those new shops are up and running after their refurbishment after the earthquake, about 10 stores there, so that was all good news there. And the other big property companies have been reporting all week, and they are getting bigger, and there's a lot of shopping centre development occurring right around the country. And I would think that possibly there's very little further shopping centre development to be found in the inner part of the city. So good news to the Carter Group going forward there. And we certainly need a little bit of a stimulus because there have been a couple of reports out that our economic growth, after we've become a bit complacent about it because of the rebuild, has been falling, dropped back in the March year to only 4.9%, still pretty good going, but it was a little bit down on where expectations were. And we were showing our lowest rate of increase in 2 years. Construction work, of course, not really coming through as strongly as anticipated, but if you go for a drive along the riverside now, you'll see the new new office tower starting to be built. Of course, in terms of consumption by consumers, we're riding high, about at a 9-year high there. Registrations for cars, a 9-year high. Unemployment right down very low, only 3.2% in the Canterbury area, and a record, of course, for house prices. On the stock market, just to close with a quick comment upon that Superstock Zero, which reported today. Of course, this stock is driven by sales of software accounting systems across the planet now. Its revenue was up 83% in the year to $70 million. They said they had $200 million worth of cash left for future growth. And just this week, the Forbes magazine group ranked Xero number one in the world for the most innovative growth companies on the planet. So it's grown significantly, still making a loss, however, of $35 million. A long way to go there, but it will hold the share price up, which was today, I think, at the close, about $32.35. Long way from where they started. I'm Warren Head for headliner.co.nz. If you're driving around the central city, CTV's traffic update will assist you navigating the repairs taking place.
Hello travellers, here's a few tips on how to plan your journey around the central city this week.
new work's underway on the Hereford Street Bridge. This means until it's complete, you can only travel eastbound. If you're planning to access Hereford Street west of the bridge, please use Durham Street or Montreal Street to avoid those nasty delays. A reminder, Durham Street will still be slow, particularly during those peak times, so allow extra time or consider Fitzgerald Avenue as an alternative route south. To get the latest on what's happening with the Central City roads, tune in every night at 5 o'clock for CTV News, or in the meantime, visit the Transport for Christchurch website.
And finally tonight, here's your regional weather.
Kia ora everyone, let's take a look at today's estimated temperatures. Down in South Canterbury, Timaru had 14 degrees today, Temuka and Geraldine on 14 degrees. Ashburton, 15 degrees for your Thursday, Methven also had 15 degrees, Rakaia, 15 degrees for you, Darthfield had 15 degrees today, Leeston and Rolleston also had 15 degrees today, and Lincoln, 15 degrees today for you, and Christchurch, you guessed it, 15 degrees for your Thursday. Akaroa had 15 degrees today, and out in North Canterbury, Kaipoi, Rangiora and Amberley all receiving 15 degrees as your high. Let's take a look inland now. Culverton and Hamner Springs, you both were on a 16 degree high today and 16 degrees up in Cheviot as well. And travelling further up along the east coast, Kaikoura, also 16 degrees for your Thursday. Let's take a look at the weather in your area now. Timaru, thick high cloud for most of your Friday with strong gusty westerly winds. A few spits of rain possible late afternoon. Tonight's low 9 degrees, tomorrow's high 15. Ashburton, a fine and mildish Friday in store with high cloud and gusty winds. Tonight's overnight low 9 degrees, tomorrow's high 16. And in the Garden City, a typical northwesterly Friday ahead for the city with plenty of high cloud about and gusty winds. Tonight's overnight low 9 degrees, tomorrow's high 16. Kaikoura, mostly fine with thick high cloud and fresh to strong westerly winds. Tonight's overnight low will be 9 degrees and tomorrow's high 16 degrees. Cloud will be about for most in other areas tomorrow. Let's take a look at the temperatures. Temuka and Geraldine can expect a high of 15 degrees. Methven, you'll have a 15 degree high and 15 expected in Rakaia. Darthfield, you can expect 15 degrees tomorrow, and Leeston, 16 degrees for you. Rolleston and Lincoln, 16 degrees for you as well, and Akaroa, 16 degrees expected for you. And out north of the Waimakariri, Kaipoi and Rangiora, 16 degrees is set for your Friday. And Amberley, also 16 expected there. Culverton, Hamner Springs and Cheviot, a fine day ahead with 15 degrees. Looking ahead for Canterbury, fine and mild on Saturday with high cloud and northwesterly winds becoming strong and gusty for a time. A brief southwesterly change at night will bring a few showers. Mostly fine on Sunday with sunny periods and high cloud and strong gusty westerly winds. A cold blusterly southwest change at night with a brief period of wintry showers mostly on the coast. Mostly fine on Monday with sunny periods increasing during the day but very cold, with fresh gusty southwesterly winds decreasing and dying out. Fine and sunny on Tuesday with light northerly winds and it will be cool. Mild northerlies freshening on Wednesday with high cloud increasing. And that's your weather update for Thursday. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
And that's CTV News for Thursday. I'm Grant Mangan. Good night.
supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.